This is a situation which we all come across, and as the IOL implantation has become an essential part, the IOL design, material and delivery system has gone tremendous transformation since 1949 of the Harold Ridley days of the PMMA IOL. Now we have come to such a small incision of even up to 1.8 millimeter. And most of the titration has been done about the predictability of the outcome and the technique. But uncontrolled outcome depends upon so many factors, and one of them leads to the inadvertent accidents like cracks in the IOL implants. The aim of this study was to evaluate various factors associated with IOL cracks during insertion of IOL implant, and as well as to minimize risk of inadvertent injury to the IOL while loading and implanting. We have this 500 consecutive eyes were studied over 6 months at a North India. The 350 were the hydrophobic, 150 were monoblock plate hydrophilic IOLs, and injectors designed for these two specifics were used. All the intraoperative complications of crack IOLs were determined. To avoid any bias, all cases were operated by single surgeons. Chondroitin sulfate was used. McPherson was used to handle the IOL, and under the external light conditions were maintained in operation room while loading the IOL. These are our results. That of 350 consecutive cases, 11 cases had some kind of a crack while implanting, whereas in the other group of the 150 cases, there were the 8 cases those who had cracks. And when analyzing these hydrophobic IOL cracks, entrapment in the cartridge was almost 1/3 of it, overriding of plunger in more than half, and entrapment in the wound was in the 9% cracked IOLs. This is a chart showing the causes of the cracks in the hydrophobic IOLs. When we go into the hydrophilic IOLs, it shows that 75% were due to the entrapment in the cartridge and remaining 25% due to the overriding of the plunger. No incidence of wound entrapment of IOL optic was witnessed among hydrophilic IOLs. If you further analyze these of the cracks in these 54% cases had a haptic crack or break in 2 cases, and haptic optic junctions were in the 1 case, and the combined optic and haptic break were in 18%. If you see on the hydrophilic IOLs, almost more than 1/3 had a optic crack, whereas the combined optic and haptic break was in 18% cases, and remaining had a optic-optic junction, haptic junctions in 25% cases. If you further analyze, there is a combined haptic and optic cracks was almost 100% in the crack cases due to entrapment of IOL in cartridge. Cracking at haptic-optic junction was also due to entrapment of IOL in corneal phaco wound in all cases, those who had a cracks. Now if you see with this that presently the hydrophobic acrylic and hydrophilic IOL gels are materials, those are the used in various types of the IOLs, and it was a first prospective study which was to just to analyze. All cracks IOLs are not supposed to be removed. These cracks may be the minor one in the optics also, but in 3 cases we had to have the explantation of the IOL. And therefore the choice of IOL, critical importance of loading technique, behavior of lens during molding within the cartridge, and appropriately matched cartridge caliber are factors considered for eventless uncomplicated cataract surgery outcome. Have a small video of the 2 cases, and here the loading was perfect, use the McPherson. And when it goes inside, the lens is delivered and you find that there is a crack. Obviously, this lens has to be explanted. The second one, there is a large crack in the optics. And with the experience, I thought that avoid PCR, etc., use the scaffold technique to put the IOL first and then explant it. So in this case, IOL was put first and then explantation was carried out. Thank you very much.